I'll be straight with you. I think we're past the point where I just want to use you to further my own goals. I may be starting to like you. Now, I don't want you thinking your pal Rose is going soft on you, so let me just say this. If you ever get it in your head to screw me over, I will gut you with this here saw and string your entrails up like Christmas tinsel. Nothing personal.
Thank you. A bit of situation here I want to report. I'm gonna send this here holotape with a runner to you as soon as I can. Me and the other trappers set up this camp here near Devil's Backbone just like we all agreed on. It's been working out for us. Plenty of game to catch, plenty of unlucky saps wandering in from the east still. But, you know how we said we stay out of Huntersville and don't drink the water near there? Thought it was just some sort of quarantine zone full of sick people, so we made sure not to poke at it. We started hearing some noises coming from the town a bit back, so I done reckon we'd better send someone to check it out.
phone. What is it?
Some commotion over in Huntersville. Gotta be you, huh? Yeah, I kind of figured the mutant brutes got to Walter and the Trappers. Real shame. Then again, maybe it wasn't such a bright move, sticking around when they found out the town was run amok with those big dumb glutes. Why don't you go figure out what happened to the diehards next? Probably just plain starved after Margie vanished. Bunch of useless old softies. Margie had her own room at the Sunny Top Ski Lanes. It's her last known location. See if she left anything behind.
Thank you. much junk in so little time.
Thank you.
leave here alive!
Margie McClintock of the Diehards. What a joke. We deluded ourselves into thinking our victims would fear a name like that. But now, everyone out there is as desperate as we are. And every confrontation could mean life or death. People take their chances. They fight back. So we have to kill. We have to murder innocent people. Well, not me. I don't care what this world has come to. It's not taking me down with it. The whole idea of the Raiders is sick. It's inhuman. I'm destroying that stupid key fragment. Bastards don't deserve their treasures. Unless they return to their senses and quit this whole murderous power game they're playing. If that ever happens, Vincent knows what to do. Maybe he'll be more successful than I was. As for me, I'm leaving. I'll find some chems and I'll go out that way. Peaceful. Without pain. I'm done. I'll see you soon, Harlan, my love. It's been too long.
Hide, little bleeder.
please. Don't stab other customers while they shop. Now in stock. Goods acquired through questionable means. You looking at me? How about you stop looking and start buying? Thank you.
track of you out there. I was, busy doing some stuff. And by stuff, I mean Ken's. You know, I almost feel bad for old Margie. Smart as a whip, but never did like to get her hands dirty and couldn't hack it when push came to shove. Anyway, did you find her key? Let's pretend you did and move on. I don't have all day to watch you putter about. Hey, speaking of putters, I'm not sure what you'll find at Bolton Greens, but I am sure that whatever happened to the gourmands, it was as grisly and inhuman as they were. Good luck! You'll forgive me for not watching this time.
Thank you. Please take a number and wait to be served. Please wait for your number to be called. Number to be called. Please wait for your number to be called. Please wait for your number to be called. Please wait for your number to be called. Please take a number and wait to be served. Please wait for your number to be called. Please wait for your number to be called. Thank you. Please wait for your number to be called. Please wait for your number to be called. Please take a number and wait to be served. Please wait for your number to be called. Please wait for your number to be called. Please wait for your number to be called. Please take a number and wait to be served. Please wait for your number to be called. Please wait for your number to be called. Please wait for your number to be called. Please take a number and wait to be served. Please wait for your number to be called. Thank you.
the first time I've said it out loud. It sounds strange. After the bombs hit, people kept looking to us for answers. And I tell them, don't worry, help is on the way. It's clear to me now that there's nobody left. Winter's been brutal. It started a few weeks after the bombs hit and shows no sign of letting up. Well, maybe winter's all that's left now. I remember this cave from grade school. Kids called it the Wendigo Cave. Then, absolutely terrified. Now, it's the only thing keeping us alive. We'll stay here to survive the cold. And we'll get back out there. The men trust me to keep them alive. And I haven't let them down yet. Here's hoping that record holds.
To death. I'll never ask what actually happened, though. The thought of eating another human grosses me out. Ugh. Makes me glad robots were never on their menu. So, there's one more key fragment. This one belonged to the cutthroats. David, the guy who led us, is alive. Or something like it. I saw him roaming around out there, near his favorite barbecue shack. Turn into one of those scorched things. It breaks my heart to see him like that. He could be a real jackass, but he doesn't deserve that fate. Now I'd bet anything he's still got his key fragment on him. So really, he'd be doing everyone involved a huge favor by putting him out of our collective misery. And taking the key. Kiss him goodbye for me? Actually, don't. He's probably all malformed and disgusting now. Yeah, yuck.
Edie, darling Edie. Oh, how delicious you were. The sweet taste of your flesh as it passed down my throat. Oh, the syrupy warmth of your blood as it filled my stomach. I killed her. I ate her. Oh, no. No, no, no. But I had to. I must eat. So hungry, starving, need more. More flesh, more blood, need more.
Watched you kill David through the viewfinder. So that's a thing that happened.
Hey, I'm hoping that by now you've got everything we need.
Hurry back so we can bust that cache wide open and see what's inside.
No one's been inside since before they made me, so I've been dying to see all the crazy crap they've kept hidden for all these years. Don't keep me waiting.
Thank you.
whatever your name was. You got those key fragments for me? I'll take those for safekeeping. There's just one more little thing. David, he had a mistress named Rosalind. She wound up doing something stupid out of love for the man. Tried to lead a raid on Charleston on Christmas Eve so she could bring him back something nice. Got herself killed in the process. Now, in order to create the cash master key from those passwords you got, I need the holotape program she had with her when she died. You might have to look through the town's records to find out where they buried her body. I'd start with the Capitol building. Meet me at the cache in the basement of the ski lodge when you've got that holotape.
Eliminate hostiles. Just don't let them hurt the merchandise, because we don't allow returns. That pun finish won't care for itself. Make sure you
kill all hostile forces. Additional
try not to let those bots get dinged up now.
Reprogramming complete. Initiating updated procedures.
Scanners detecting sentient life.
That polycarbonate fish won't care for itself. Make
Completion merits support commendation. Issuing to user.
Quite the number on this place, didn't they, member?
I can be of service.
Thank you.
Okay, I see you made it into the city. Well, there's something you should know, if it isn't already painfully obvious. Charleston got flooded in a bad way. When David learned they killed Rosalind, he took the mini nukes we'd stolen from the Brotherhood of Steel and rigged them to blow up the dam. Damn near wiped the entire city off the map. Last I checked, the Capitol building is still standing. If any place was gonna have records of any of this, it'd be there. Here's hoping you don't have to dig up half the town to find what you're looking for.